We could be arrested. It's
provocation by the West.
100 rubles later you give me?
Yeah, later. Hi, Sergey.
Hello, Balnur.
How are you doing?
Oh, great, but want to sleep a little bit.
It's my pleasure to have you on my channel. And thank you for meeting us here. And tell me, please, Sergey, where are we right now? Just to know
about
this place. We're
in St. Petersburg, in the suburbs, like historical place, where emperors lived in summer palaces, you know, like, yeah. Oh. And I live in some one of the palace here, but still donate me money, like, you know, I'm just worker there, simple worker.
Okay, I got it. So let's continue our walk. Well, the first question is, I'm quite wondering, why did you call your channel Crazy Russian Sergey? Why exactly crazy?
Well, because it's kind of popular thing, like cliche, I don't know, stereotype, popular thing about Russians that they are crazy. And even like maybe 10 years ago, Russians were popular for being crazy on YouTube, you know?
Do you make and, videos about beers?
Beers? No, but it's just if I named it just Russian Sergey, it wouldn't be so interesting. But it's not only me, you know? When I wanted to name this channel like that, I found the channel of Crazy Russian Dad, so-called. Okay. He was the first. Then, before that, I found the Crazy Russian Hacker, who even older channel. And it's a lot of crazy Russians, but we all kind of got this idea by our own, you know? So I didn't steal my channel's name.
Okay.
I'm not crazy, it's just Bert.
Okay, fine. Tell me, please, how did you start your YouTube channel? How did you decide, like,
no, I started from the Russian channel. I had a Russian channel before. Because from the beginning, from my childhood, I wanted to become a football player, to play for Zenit, Arsenal and Real Madrid. But it didn't happen, you know. Then I wanted to do something else, to become still famous and rich and to do something interesting. And I thought, oh, YouTube. And I saw those pranks of so-called Vitaly ZDTV, who lives in America, Russian prankster in 2013. And I started to do pranks. Maybe you can put some crazy moments from my pranks. Yeah, but then, like, it was slowly Russian channel, and I wanted to start an English channel. But I didn't start it for a long time. But then the pandemic started, and I stopped traveling.
Yeah.
And I saw, oh, this is a perfect opportunity to start filming in English, in Mother Russia, you know?
Okay.
And yeah, like, yeah, that's how I started.
Okay, I saw your videos
Then I quit Russian YouTube because from American YouTube I got like maybe 10 times more money than from Russian YouTube. And on my Russian YouTube it's like 10 times more subscribers.
Oh yeah, I saw that.
And now Google cut the
income
from Russian viewers, so I need to explore the Western capitalist. Now it's the only way
to get
money.
Okay. And I saw your videos when you lived in Soviet apartment. Was it difficult to live in that kind of conditions, or do you still live?
No, it's actually, it was even better. Like, for me, you know, it's important just like the quietness, that no one disturbs you.
Yeah.
But for me, it's okay to live in these conditions because the only like maybe bad conditions were that when I moved there, it was a lot of spiders there.
Okay.
You know, but then, and in Russia, we can't remove spiders from life. I don't know if you can pronounce this word, like, you know. it's a bad superstition, so we need to let them leave.
Yeah.
But still, I cleaned the apartment a lot and spiders disappeared next, like, in 6 months maybe, completely. It was the only problem, but another problem is that girls, they didn't like that apartment, you know? So, and also when they saw my tent, they thought I'm crazy, you know? If I would tell them about it, they also would say, you understand what I mean.
Okay, I got it. So, what kind of places have you been to in Russia that you shoot video to your YouTube channel? What kind of cities or villages?
People there, I'm shying. But okay, yeah, I've been to Sochi. Yeah, in the village of the north of Russia, in Sochi, in the south of Russia, on the Black Sea, in Moscow, capital of Russia, where they all have all the money. But they're not as cultural as St. Petersburg people, where I'm from.
Mm-hmm.
But they have more money, I have to admit, than us. But where I was... Kazan, you also
We've been
to Kazan. Nizhny Novgorod. Yeah, I think that's all where I filmed the videos. I've been to more places, but yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. But soon I'm gonna visit some places, but I won't tell you which, so you won't steal this cool idea.
Like keeping secret.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so nice. Well, I've heard on your speech that you've been in USA, in the USA.
Yeah.
And can you compare life in the USA and in Russia, like just specific points?
Good questions you prepared. Well, I can say good things and bad things.
Okay, let's divide first good things, then bad things.
Uh-huh. Yeah, just about bad is simpler to talk.
Okay.
But okay, good things, like, in America, like, I don't know, you feel this kind of freedom. I even remember when I landed there on the Russian Aeroflot plane, it was mostly Russians there, or Russians who live in America and stuff.
Yeah.
And I remember some guy entered to America after the border patrol, like, and screamed in the airport, "Svoboda!" Like, freedom. He was half joking, like, but yeah, you kind of feel this kind of freedom, you know. For example, you can date with, like, woman of other nationality, you know, and it depends, but in some New York, for example, nobody cares about it. But in Russia, if you do it, for example, people would turn around at you, like, "Well, what's that?" And, or what else, like, in pizza, when you buy pizza in United Governments of America, like, they put a lot of chicken. In Russia, they put a little bit of chicken, you know, just like chick-chick-chick-chick. But in America, it's like, you really feel full after it. So big portions, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Bad things in America, it's like that it depends. America, all very different. But, for example, most of the time I spent in New York studying English for 2 months. And New York is like, sorry, Americans, but it's one of the dirtiest cities I've been to in my life. And it's full of rats and also crazy people, sometimes on the streets. I had some stories there. But in the same time, it's interesting there. It's always something happening, in America.
Yeah.
I am planning, like, I was in America, like, 9 years ago. So maybe when political situation will calm down and I'll get more rich, I want to travel through the whole of America and film the video, like, coming back to America 10 years later, like, Crazy Russian in America, Syria, something like that. Don't steal these ideas, Russians.
Okay,
the
fine.
Russian YouTubers, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I saw there are a lot of Russian YouTubers since this political situation has happened. Like many Russian YouTubers.
Wait, can I smoke?
Maybe later, please.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, fine. Let's turn back to the beginning of our speech. You said that we are in St. Petersburg. Why people call this place as a cultural center of Russia, well, like cultural city?
Well, we have a lot of museums, and from the last kind of couple of hundred years, all the elite lived here, like, because it was the capital, and most of this, like, kind of, like, you see, I come from the Gopnik neighborhood, so I'm not that good at culture. But yeah, it's because of that. We have a lot of museums, culture and stuff. And also we are considered to be more polite. You know, if you travel through the whole Russia, everywhere you go, they say good stuff about St. Petersburg people, which you don't hear a lot about Moscow people. Everywhere in Russia, people don't really like Moscow people. But in English, you have to speak some carefully because we could be arrested, you know, maybe.
Yeah. Okay. Should we wait until they will go?
Yeah, better, you know.
Okay, let's continue what you were talking.
I forgot. I'm blonde. I forgot.
Okay, about this city.
Yes, there is, you know, YouTuber, he's got the same name as me, Sergei Baklikov, so he is more into culture, and you can interview him later, maybe.
Okay.
And, yeah, he will tell you more, even though he is not from St. Petersburg, but I'm sure he knows even more than me.
Okay.
Yeah, I am from Gopnik neighborhood. If you ask me about, like, types of local beer and stuff, yeah, I can tell you, but...
Okay, fine. So, over this year, like, since February, I could say, like, many Russian people and also other countries are facing many difficulties because of the Western sanctions. And can you tell me just your point of view, do you see any changes in Russia? Like, what has changed?
What was this question? Past the censorship, like, did you give it to the captain Ivanov? He agreed with this question?
No. I mean, what kind of changes do you see here in Russia? What has changed?
No, everything is good, like, I think, you know, like, nothing really changed. And yeah, maybe better next question, I don't know.
Okay, do you see there are people who are really concerned about the sanctions here in Russia? Or people living
sanctions,
like their daily lives, and they don't really feel anything?
Sanctions affected me. First I thought they won't affect me that much. But now I understand, like, I was in the village recently, no one cares about sanctions there because they don't affect them at all. But I thought they will be maybe more affected. Maybe, yeah, some factories will be affected and stuff. But I am affected a lot as well. But still, at least YouTube, I wanted to say thanks to YouTube and Google that despite all the difficulties in Russia and stuff, in Russia they fine Google for billions of rubles fines. Yeah. You know, they sue Google and stuff, but Google still gives me money from YouTube. So respect to them. I mean, I don't get money from Russian viewers, but it's just 3% of my channel, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, are you satisfied with life in Russia, or do you see your future maybe in another country?
I've always wanted to travel. even before all of this stuff which happened this year, my plan was that I will film everything I want in Russia, and it's maybe like half a year left, and then I'll start traveling and film and live in other countries for a long time. Like, you know, maybe I will leave Russia for 6 months, but then I will always come back and stuff, because I don't want to emigrate, you know? I don't want to leave Russia forever, because many people want to do it now. But yeah, it's my motherland, you know? I can't like choose it. Oh, look what interesting road.
Okay, let's go like this.
Yeah. And so yeah, I'm not planning to immigrate or emigrate, yeah.
Okay.
But what was the question? Wait, I remember.
Are you satisfied with life in Russia?
You know, I would be satisfied only if I wasn't bored here. It's not even about like sanctions or stuff, or like political situation. Even before all of that, you know, I'm getting bored here because I've lived here for a long time. So I want to live in another country just because I want new emotions and stuff. Yeah. I don't know if I answered this question, but yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but yeah.
So, crazy Sergei, would you tell me, do Russian people or Russian government really want to reunion all former Soviet Union countries? And what might be reason of this?
No, maybe in a way, but not even a Soviet Union, but kind of a Russian empire. Because current Russian government is not like communist and stuff. So, and I'm afraid to talk about it, but the big man, the big guy, you know, he is more of the fan of the Russian Empire than the Soviet Union. It's not like a secret. And so maybe, but I don't even think they want to recreate it, like to control it, but they want to have an influence on these territories, you know, like.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, do you see in this idea any trouble that many nations might forget their own language? Like, if we're gonna again reunion, it might be that Kazakh
Russian
people
language.
Might forget. Yeah, Kazakh people might forget Kazakh language. Like, I mean, this kind of trouble. Do you see it might be?
Yes, it could be, because I was in Belarus and almost no one speaks Belarusian now. So yeah, it can happen. Yeah,
so we've been also in Altai Republic and in Tatarstan. And when I interviewed people and I asked if they can speak their native like language, it was difficult for them just to tell even simple sentence, and they say that they already used to speak only Russian.
Yeah, in news I spoke to some Tatar girls before on the work, and I asked them if they speak Tatar language. Yeah, and they said like, oh, a little bit.
Yeah.
And when they go to the village, to their babushkas are angry at them that they forget their language, you know, because babushka speaks to them in Tatar, but they respond to them in Russian. And babushkas are angry, Tatar babushkas, about it. I understand in a way those babushkas, you know.
Yeah.
So.
So if you put yourself to the place of that babushka, maybe in the future you will live in another country, and what will be your action? Will you teach your children to speak fluently in Russian language, or it doesn't matter for you as much as the babushka?
Well, if you live in one country, you know, it's like maybe it's needed in this way to speak Russian, you know, to learn it. So, but maybe not to forget Tatar language as well, and maybe more lessons in Tatar language to have more. But yeah, it's like that. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, are there a lot of people in Russia?
Yeah, just in Russia we are like considered more imperialistic, you know. I'm not, but like, oh, Russian language should be everywhere. So yeah, I'm like, yeah.
Okay, are there a lot of people in Russia who follow some kind of traditions, Russian traditions, or young people maybe don't care about traditions here?
Well, you know, traditions maybe going away, but I noticed that superstitions are still working. Like, I was in the village, like, it's like, oh, you need to close the salt because it's bad superstition. And it's a lot of superstitions. You just don't think about them, but...
But do you know the reason of that thing? Like, why? What will happen if you don't close the...
Yeah, and you can't kill spiders, you know? I don't know why, but it's important, you know? It's important. We need to keep it, I think. Because, yeah,
I
just, you know, a little bit, yeah. If, you know, I don't really believe in it, but just in case, because who knows, like, if you remove spider from life, you won't have money, like Russian superstition says. Or yeah, also if you whistle in the house, you won't have money. I don't believe in it, like, really, but who knows, like, you know, I still don't have money, but...
I agree with you with that superstitions, because Kazakh people also superstitious. Yeah,
yes.
They're really, yeah. Maybe we have also mixed Russian superstitious being and Kazakh superstitious, and that's why we have mixed a lot of superstitions.
Yeah, you have double.
Doubles.
Double superstitions.
Yeah. Well, and the next question is, what kind of YouTube bloggers do you follow on, like Russian YouTube bloggers do you follow and watch their videos? Whom do you know?
First YouTuber I kind of started to talk to was Zangief from Moscow, the Russian man from Russia, or how he says, like, he's very big and strong, so he was my roof, Krisha.
Wow.
It's like protection, Russian slang word in Moscow. Yes, and I watched all of his videos till full, but no, complete full video.
Yeah.
But other YouTubers I also watch, but not maybe all of the videos, and sometimes I skip their videos. I'll watch few minutes of the videos. Also I watch this Natasha from Yeah, Russia channel. Maybe she has a little bit different political views than me, because she talks a lot about it, you know. But we are all different, but by some reason I'm interested. I watch till the end her videos. You know, she has this talent of talking, maybe like showing stuff and this thing. But Dairy Step, she is very beautiful, and it was Stella the Russian, but she is not filming now that much. Konstantin, I watched him from inside Russia. I watched him quite a lot before, but now he films every day and long live streams, and it's about like Russia, and he has his own opinion, but he discussed like Russia, and I kind of know the stuff about Russia. He just discussed with
foreigners,
yeah, mostly Americans, I think. So I'm not like maybe much interested of it. But his live streams before, when he filmed on the street, you know, almost like fighting with someone, I remember. And he's very strong as well, so
yeah.
It's good to have a friend like that, because they can be your roof, you know, as I said, like.
I wish I would have that kind of roofs in my life.
Mm.
Okay, fine. I saw many YouTube bloggers who immigrated or moved to another country because of the current situation here in Russia. And do you think if these people or other people also can get rid of trouble being in another country, or they might face also this kind of troubles in another country?
You mean sanctions, or like the foreign
as being Russian
citizen. Yeah, like I forgot that word, but yeah, I understand you. Yeah, I think it depends on the country, you know. For example, I've heard in Turkey, it's still good relations with Russians. It's like, for them, it's like not their kind of problem, you know. They kind of happy for everyone. It's like maybe tourist country, everyone comes in. Maybe in some countries like in Western Europe, and not maybe only even Western Europe, but some maybe former Soviet bloc countries like Poland, there maybe Russians could have some problems and negative attitude to Russians. So, but I think if I go to Asia, it still will be normal. For example, a lot of Russians now moved to Georgia, but in Georgia, even before this year, it still was not the best kind of attitude to Russians, especially between the young people. I understand them, but you know, if you are not the politician, it's still you can have some problems there, you know, like just, yeah. So maybe I wouldn't move there now, but a lot of even Russian YouTubers moved there to Georgia now. But I was in Georgia, it's excellent country, very hospitable people and stuff. But maybe some one crazy guy out of 100,000 people, you know, yeah, so maybe now I wouldn't go there. But to Western world, I think even if they would have bad attitude to you, to as a Russian, some people, they still won't beat you. You know, they just maybe, yeah, this or that.
What can you say?
But my English is very bad.
What can you say? Can we define Russian people as the Russian government? Or what you can say to the viewers that not all of the Russian people are the same?
Well, to be honest, I think I'll tell the truth to you now.
Okay, tell me.
Most of Russians, I think, nowadays support the Russian government now, because it's always like that. Not always, but, you know, in history, if it's like some operations going on, you know what I mean, kind of like,
yeah,
people like kind of start using government, using propaganda, and people forget about other problems, economy and stuff, and like, yeah, so yeah. But still, yeah, not all Russians are the government, and yeah, it's like, no, let's make an example with Germans, maybe, you know, Germans, like, you know the history of them, it's like, yeah, like, but Germans are, not all of Germans are bad people, you know, maybe they're a bit boring sometimes, but they're very good people, and smart people, and good engineers, stereotypes, but, yeah.
Okay.
I have German subscribers, good guys, like, you know.
Okay, fine.
Carol. Also, what's his name? Wait, I should give a respect, I forgot. Dirk, yeah.
Is he a supporter?
No, subscriber. He sent me once $2.50 in Super Chat. So, yeah, maybe supporter a little bit.
Okay.
Carol sent me for Big Macs.
Thank you, guys.
Big Macs, McDonald's left Russia. You could ask me about that, by the way.
Yeah, I will ask.
Yeah, but I'm on a diet now, so, yeah.
What do you think about
By the way, guys, yeah, you see, you asked me about the St. Petersburg cultural capital. I just took it from my pocket. You see, I show you. I didn't throw it, you know, on the street. I put it in my pocket too, because there was no trash cans around. That's why we are cultural capital. Yeah.
What do you think about new McDonald's, Вкусная Иточка?
Yeah, I didn't eat it yet because I'm on a diet now. And I was in the village for 2 months, but I entered it once now, a few days ago, and it looked the same, so I don't know. But I think it will stay the same, like, some people say, like, It's not Soviet tractor. It will be sanctioned, maybe, you know, this Photon, I don't know. Belarus, Russian tractor, so Belarusian tractor. What I was talking about? McDonald's.
McDonald's.
Вкусный, that's it. Tasty, that's it. Yeah, вот. I saw some pictures or videos that, we found some rat in Russian new McDonald's, you know, or some, I don't know, bad quality and stuff, but I don't know, but because I didn't eat it yet, but I just guess it's because of the hype, you know, everyone goes filming about this new McDonald's and like from 100,000 times it was one rat in one big tasty, I think, sanctioned now. They use different names.
Big Mac.
And, yeah, Big Mac also sanctioned, I think.
Yeah,
Big Mac, yeah. And, for example, from 100,000 Big Macs, there was one rat in one Big Mac. And they, some bloggers, took this picture of it. And it's become a hype because it's now a hype, you know, because everyone goes and film everywhere this new McDonald's. So, but I think it will stay the same. Maybe, yeah, maybe a bit less control, quality control. But I think I eat Russian fast food. My favorite is not McDonald's. My favorite is Russian fast food called Mega Burger in St. Petersburg. You know, visit this place one time. It's Russian one. So it quality is good there. Yeah, I eat shawarma. You know, maybe it's made from dogs sometimes, and it's still fine for me. Yeah. It's maybe for, yeah.
How we should pronounce correctly, shawarma или шаурма?
Yes, that's interesting question. In St. Petersburg, you say shawarma.
Really?
Yeah, and everywhere else in Russia, like they say, I can't even remember the accent of on the word. Is it шаурма or шаурма?
Шаурма, maybe.
Шаурма, yeah, maybe шаурма. And yeah, but here we say шаверма. And it's written everywhere.
Is it Turkish traditional dish?
No, it's kind of Arabic, Turkish, I don't know. In Turkey it's called kebab, you know?
Yeah.
In Middle Asia, like, it's called shawarma or shawarma, I don't know. Shawarma in some countries it's called.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... It's provocation by the West, maybe. Okay, now I'm kidding, but yeah.
Let's sum up all of our questions and all of your answer. And the next question, the last question will be, are you proud of Russia and are you proud of being a Russian citizen?
I think I'm still... Okay, let's say it this way for today's situation. I'm not ashamed of being Russian, because some Russians like kind of ashamed of being Russian nowadays. But I just don't support what's going on right now, you know. I wasn't even very big, because it's in a way a political question still. I wasn't even that much in a position before, but I just don't support what happened this year, you know, what's happened. And it's just history shows us that in every country had some bad. Some, it's, you know, half of Russia thinks it's good what's going on now, but it's like everywhere. For example, sorry, like, but best example, maybe in Germany many people thought they do some good stuff, but then it appears it was very bad stuff. Ну, you know, long time ago. And in America, like, in America, it's like, you know, with colonization, for example, with the Native Americans. Ну, in general, like colonization, and not even Europeans did all of that. Like, some in other countries, in Africa, still, like, a lot of people fight. There were, like, massacres, genocides in Asia, in China, in Myanmar, Burma, like, maybe it's whataboutism, yeah, but... you know, it happened everywhere. And I just hope the peaceful good time will come faster, you know. So yeah, I'm sorry if I've offended someone, but it's just I'm saying the how I think, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
So thank you, Sergey, for your answer, for being so open-minded. And thank you guys for watching this video till the end. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, to click the like button, and to drop your comments. Maybe you have your own answer for all of my questions. So see you guys soon. Goodbye.
100 rubles later you give me?
Yeah, later.
Okay,
let's go. Only 100 rubles?
1,000.
You said 100?
No, I said 1,000.
What did you hear? I heard that 100. Okay, fine.